twice because he felt the eight tentacles, yuck, would represent the eight wins required to win the Cup. Not only did they win eight, they won eight straight, sweeping the Canadians and the Maple Leafs, and hence all the octopi here at the arena.
That was when Terry Sawchuk his first year, four shutouts. All right, we're going to show this here. Great series coming up. You know what I predicted? Here, take that.
Yeah, well, geez. Disgusting.
I've done a lot of nutsy things on Hockey Night in Canada, but that was the worst. See McLean jump? Well, here we are at the Great Hockey Hall of Fame. I'll tell you, it's beautiful here. And we're honored to do Rock'em Sock'em 7 here. So you ready? Let's go. Well, here it is, folks, the Stanley Cup. I'll tell you, folks, to win this, you got to have a lot of hard work and sweat. And you know, to win it, you have to pay the price. You think not? Watch this.
Hey, Ty, admiring a pass. Look out, Dennis. And here's Glenn Featherstone working in the pits. I love these guys. And Dino Cicerelli paying the price in the corners. Hey, you can't beat these guys. Nice elbow. Hey, folks, you can tell it's the playoffs. And that's what I mean, paying the price. Now watch these magic hands. Hey, let's see that again in slow-mo. Nifty move by Fedorov to Kozlov. Hey, I gotta admit, that's a great move. Hey, instead of magic hands, it's magic feet by Jenny. You know, I'm often asked, what do I mean by second effort? Now, just watch my buddy Cam. What a beauty he is. And watch Sakic feather these passes. Boy, I love that Wendell. Basson to Krug to Basson and in. Yeah, I'm going to tell you, the Avalanche are going to miss this little grinder. Hey, my buddy, little Stevie Wonder starts it to Sillinger, to Shepherd. A little hesitation, and in the top corner, beauty. The captain, Mark Messier, to tough guy, Nick Kiprios. Nice heads, Nick. And Nick says, nice one, Mark. Okay, now watch these two beauties by Adam Oates. You know, folks, he's the unknown superstar of the league. How many of you knew he had more points than anybody in the league in the last 4 years? And with Kevin Stevens, you know it's going to continue. Kilburn one-handed to Tardif. Okay, nice play by the MVP, Claude Lemieux, to Scott Stevens. Back to Claude and in. Hey, Pavelka, to my favorite Dale Hunter. Remember what I said, kids, stick on the ice. Tic-tac-toe, Kotowalchuk. Gee, I love that name. To Dale and to Jones. A nice one to Bill Guerin, to Rawson, and to Branson. Hey, what a lovely pass. Woo-wee! Cavallini to Gilchrist. I love these second efforts, folks. And that's again, I love magic hands and second efforts.
Well, anyhow, I want to say something. A little Ferreira guy running Patrick Waugh, and that is absolutely ridiculous to me. Nothing happens to the guy. You're going to say, why did Nodaline or somebody do something? Think of this a few years ago. Somebody runs Dryden like that. Butch Bouchard, Pierre to nail him, Robinson to nail him. You can't now. It's open season. The big defenseman used to take care of the goaltenders. Can't now because the instigator rule, the worst rule ever put into sports. It's open season on guy. See him go like this?
Do you think he gets maybe run into or what?
Doesn't matter. Watch. Watch this here coming now. Look. Now watch. Watch his left arm, as Dick said. Watch him following through. He follows through and gives him a shot like that. I mean, you know. Yeah, shut up, you little...
You know, folks, ever since they've taken the pipes out of the goalposts, they were big, long ones, held the nets right in there. Watch these guys. They know they're not going to get hurt. They have no respect for the goalies at all. Let's watch. Kenny Raggett's mad. He's not gonna take it anymore. You know, folks, I always hated this. You know what goalies hate the most? Is when they make a save, they've got the puck, after the whistle, and that's when they get whacked. No way. Hey, this is a dive. Woo-wee, that is no dive. He's one of those guys, and he won't take it. All right, kids, now come on. Let's have a little respect for the goalie. Look at Irby. Cuts Kennedy for 40 stitches. You know, folks, one of the most amazing things in hockey that really gets me is watching the goalies react to rebound, starting with one of my buddies, Eddie the Eagle. Tabarachi. Russo. new cell again. Defoe. Jocelyn Thibault. The Boulin Wall. Healy. Locker. Richter. Jacqueline Cost, or something like that. Now watch Norm McIver make two saves in a row here. I know it's not rebounds, but watch LA's Kelly Rudy stop two penalty shots. This one by Fedorov in OT beauty. Boy, what a great save here. That's strictly Hollywood.
Bobby Orr, the greatest hockey player who ever lived and whoever will live, scoring that overtime goal. Look at him flying through the air. I'll take a gander at these OT goals, starting with Chicago's Hard Rock defenseman, Chris Chelios.
Okay, now remember on Coach's Corner in the playoffs, I said, watch the defenseman scoring an OT. Watch, coming in late now. Watch this beauty. And look, nobody picks him up again. Got to pick up that late guy and Jay Thu all over again. Now remember, kids, like I always said, keep that stick on the ice. You never know where the puck's going to come from. Now watch this. See what I mean? If that stick had been up 6 inches, he wouldn't have scored. Stick on the ice all the time when you're around the net. Hey, we made Kirk look pretty bad. Now watch these beauties that keep them in there. And now some nice move by the Cat. Hey, Poulin can't believe it. He stole Savard here. He's getting his head screwed on right. Hey, folks, to me, this is one of the worst things that happened in hockey last year. Watch Elliott put it right in the guy's beer. Whoa, what a waste. Hey, two guys getting their wires crossed. Hey, way to go, Benoit. At least you didn't lie there. You give it the old try. Hey, sometimes your teammates can be your worst enemies. Remember, kids, protect yourself at all times. Hey, Mikey Vernon says nobody's gonna score on this net. Hey, folks, I wonder what Iron Mike had to say about this one. Boy, this is a goalie's nightmare when it banks the shot off the glass. I tell you, they hate this one. Way to go, Roger, boy. You had a beat all the way. Hey, Irby, look asleep on this one, folks. But Oskin had no chance on this one. Get out of the way! But Westfall says, I take what they gives me. Hey, folks, I wonder how long it's going to take Raymond to get to know the new building like he knew the old gardens. They were the best.
Hookerblom and Owen Nolan, what happened there?
All right, here we go. You kids out there, when you hear from the bench, you know this one. Look out! You know you're in the trolley tracks. You know you're in the trolley tracks, right? All right. Owen Nolan is one of those guys. I've seen him do it five times before. Instead of trying to get out of the way, instead of trying to do this, what he tries to do, he goes aggressive and tries to hurt guys. And that's, and Bookaboom just let up just a little bit, and I'll show you what Owen Nolan does when you try to hit him. Let's see it right now.
And in fairness, Jeff Bookaboom might have had a cross check if it weren't for the fact he's lying cold.
Got a little suey. See, bang! See the elbow come up? This guy is murder. See him come through? And Bookaboom, when you see a guy like Bookaboom laying there, folks, you know
he's
hurt.
See, we're out of time.
Hey, folks, you know what a suicide pass is? Watch this one. You know what these are called? Sueys. In other words, setting your team up to get nailed. Dumb. Yeah, it's broken. Thanks for asking. Nice pass, though. Hey, folks, let's just sit back and watch the action.
Shot. It was the best game. They will not quit. I felt so sorry for the rookie that All you kids out defensively, when you're in overtime, never fool around the net. Get it away because they come blitzing. If somebody had to score and beat the Bruins, and I hate to say it, Randy McKay, he's the guy I want to do it. But I'll tell you, that was a great game they played.
Okay, folks, all you young defensemen out there, don't be fooling around with the puck near your net in OT, because look what can happen. Gee, I feel sorry for Roloff, but don't worry, he'll bounce back. Look at Jock. He even feels sorry for him. Well, maybe a little bit. Hey, folks, remember what I said about Murphy's goal about keep your stick on the ice when you're around the net? Watch this one. A nice move by McLean and Broughton snaps it in, and is he happy or what? Well, folks, everybody knows an OT. Just put it on the net. You never know what's going to happen. Folks, I got to tell you, this is a classic at full tilt. Fakes top corner and slides it home. Hey, here's my buddy Steve Larmer. The New York Rangers are going to miss this guy. He should be a Hall of Famer for sure. This goal sent Quebec to Colorado.
Here's Terry Sawchuk, the greatest goaltender of all time. Just check the records. Terry had the sweetest glove, and these guys coming up aren't too shabby either. Let's go!
Curtis Joseph Cujo. Cujo again. Stefan Fassad. My buddy Sean Burke. J.B. McClellan. Blocker. Mikey Vernon on the great one. Hey, you gotta be pretty good to make a save on the great one. Don Beaupre. Kay Whitmer. Jim Carrey, he's smoking for a while. Trevor Kidd. Don Beaupre again. The Terminator, Dominic Hasek. Hey, Pat Roy, nobody does it better than Patrick. Mike Torsha. My buddy Glenn Haley, keep your eye on the puck at all times. The Cat in 99. Damian Rhodes stops a point blanker. Damian Rhodes again with a beauty. Hey, these things break a goalie's heart. You know what I call them? Tricklers. Mikey Vernon makes a stop, and Millen gets an easy one. Hey, Fassad gets a piece of Tenorti's shot. Hey, folks, it's enough to make you cry. Hey, remember that one? I still don't think it was in. One for Darren Boy. Get on now. The net cam catches this one on Richter. Hey, folks, it's a funny one. Yeah, it's funny to everybody but Kirk. Another one on Richter. Solani sneaks this one by Billy Radford. Fleury, he can score from anywhere, folks.
Rangers, Eric Lindros, about a minute and a half.
All right, good. You remember 3 years ago, folks? Remember I said 3 years ago, and you all laughed at me when Solani got 76 goals, mm-hmm. and everybody said, he wants Eric Lindros to be at 76 goals. Now, I'm not here to knock Solani because he had a bad injury and he's coming back. I'm not here to knock him. But I said, I'm going to check with you people, and it was around this time in 3 years. Who would you want on your club, Lindros or Solani? And I guess who you want. And 3 months ago, I said he'd win the most valuable player and the scoring title,
right,
which he will.
He didn't, though.
Listen, you're saying he didn't win. I say he's co-winner. And I say it should be co-winner, and I'll tell you why. A baseball, when they have a batting title and they end up tied, do they say home runs?
Oh, I agree with you 100%.
It should be games played, and you know the way he plays, he's going to play less. I'm not knocking Jagr. I'll tell you one thing. I watched him, not my cup of tea. He's a pretty good hockey player, but I tell you, I think his hair is getting longer. When he gets hurt out on the ice, they don't know whether to call a trainer or his hairdresser.
Hey, folks, let's watch the Hart Trophy winner, Eric Lindros, destroy a few guys. Here's another reason why I like him. I can believe this, Messier was his hero. Hey, Eric, don't get mad. He shows no mercy. Condition out, but he can take it too. You're going to pay for that, Alfie. And don't forget, he can put the puck in the net. Remember this one, folks, in overtime? Nice low hard shot. And now some more beauty OT goals. They're all beautiful. Carl Dykhouse, he's the lowest paid guy in the league. But remember, folks, like I've always said, just put it on the net, you never know. And here's another unsung hero, defenseman Kevin Holler, right for the top corner. Way to go, Kevin, boy. You see what I said, folks? Young defensemen, listen to me. Just join in the play in OT. And here's how the Flyers got into the playoffs. Watch these saves by Ronnie Hextall. Jason Dawes says, oh, I just can't believe it. Ronnie uses his head on this one. Well, you can see, folks, Ronnie has learned to keep his cool a little anyhow. Well, maybe not.
Coach's Corner with Don Cherry.
Henry, you know, wait a minute. I'm telling the story. Well, get over
sorry.
There. Will you take it over this whole thing?
You know what he did.
What? And you know he did a good job shadowing
Spear, me. Don't get me going now. Oh, no, nice. Never mind, my dear.
Hey, wait a minute.
19-8 where the shots Eddie Belfour looked sharp. Toblake died today, Don.
Who looked sharp? Eddie Belfour looked sharp.
He looked sharp. Great block.
He had eight shots. What about Potvin?
Well, yeah, he looks sharp, too.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, though, if they got to conquer, they got to come back.
Get out of the...
She must be at the concession.
Keep quiet.
To keep off my toe, I know you're getting excited here.
Kelly was a little upset, though. You know, he loves to be on Hockey Night in Canada, but in 1991, we did game one, funny enough, after Tiikkanen had scored to knock out Calgary. Edmonton goes down to the Great Western Forum in Inglewood, California. A little surprise for you. This is how you open the telecast at the Great Western Forum in Los Angeles. Game you want to talk about any of the players involved in this classic?
Yes, I want to first of all talk about Kelly Rudy. Here comes Kelly right now. Here's Kelly right. He's coming in right now. And I love the little, we'll pick him up. I love the little blue string that hangs from the back. Don't you? I love him. You can see the little string there. See, isn't that? I think it's blue chiffon. It fits right in with the LA image.
4 years later, I still got beads of sweat on my forehead.
Dale Hunter, did you know that Dale Hunter left? You know why they got rid of Dale Hunter?
No, I can't believe it.
Because he broke, he broke his leg. He went back into the playoffs and he played with screws and they were loose like that and they got rid of him. Never been the same since.
Yes, absolutely. You know, as far as Dale Hunter, the one thing I will say about the screws in his leg, him not making it stupid, you're right. I've seen a lot of very successful people with screws loose. Sometimes it's just the threads are faulty.
Well, okay, first of all, we're going to have a little lessons today, okay, you kids, you watching out there? Now, look, McLean's goal, wait a minute, don't run it. McLean's goal is very good goal. Guy cuts around the outside. Who was it? Forget who it was. Cuts around the outside, and now he drops it in. He drops it back. Now, watch the forward. He's following the puck. He's looking where the puck goes. When you see a guy going around the defenseman and he can't get in, the first thing you do is you look back. Who's coming? Because as Paul Baxter says, this guy's not dangerous, the guy's coming. You always pick up the guy coming back. Let's see McLean's goal right now. You'll watch it right now. Here it comes right now. Now watch the guy.
Billy Guerin.
Sauntered back. Billy Guerin, good guy, Billy Guerin. Now watch, he beats the guy, but he can't get by him. So now that there forward should have been looking. He's looking at the puck, bang. Should went over and take him. Always pick up the last guy coming back. All right, I got lots of time. Okay, Marty McSorley, good guy. Now you're going to say, good guy. What about the time he tried to hit Dougie along the blue line?
Right.
Showed
caught him with
in
an
the
elbow.
Play. Caught him with an elbow. If he's dug enough to go along the blue line, he deserves it. But watch here. Don't roll it yet, Eddie. Watch here. When he hits the boards, he comes back, and he's really going to nail the guy. If it had been Reichel or somebody, he'd have nailed him. He'd have really had some fun. But he saw it was a smaller player, and he's not a bully. He's a sportsman. Now roll it, Eddie, and see what he does when he sees it's a smaller player. justifiably, he gets run by Dougie, turns around, and he was going to whack him. I love those guys. I absolutely love them. That's the way to be. Be a sportsman. You kids out there, if you're a big guy, please, don't pick on the little guy. If he's dumb enough to get in the trolley tracks, you're going to have to hit him. But don't go out of your way to pick on a smaller player. That's no good. That's being a bully, and everybody hates a bully, right?
Yes, remember
that. Canadian way. What?
Remember that, I say.
Anyhow, remember you kids, I've told you one-on-one, I've been trying to get a real good one to show you, because that's what the coach. Watch Carney on Fedorov on this one. Watch how he does a look at the puck. Are we going to roll it? Go ahead and roll it. Now watch how he keeps his eye. Watch now. He never looks down at the puck. My luck, he looked down. See, looking right, got him right in the chest. That's the way to do it. Forget that puck, and you'll make the team.
You were also very upset about Brendan Shanahan. Oh.
Of all the things in the last 10 years I've had and watched, this is upsets me the most. We had a great thing, Coach's Corner, on him. He's just scored a hat trick. After Coach's Corner, he goes out and scores a goal, and then he breaks his ankle. And you know, all you kids, I've been divvying it to all those guys laying on the ice. Watch this guy. Go ahead and roll it. Watch this guy with a broken ankle. Watch this. Now, look, he's got a broken ankle. Look at him. He jumps over the boards. That's the kind of guy you want. Brendan Shanahan, God love him, watch. I've had a broken ankle, folks. It is the most painful thing in the world. I tell you, you cry, you're in such pain. And this is the thing that's upset me more in the last 10 years that I've been on Hockey Night in Canada. Kids out there, always give credit. Kozlov, he got hit. Let's see it right now, and he got up. Okay, now you've seen this one. Whack, he comes across. This is trolley tracks cutting in the center, kids. Remember I told you, cutting in the center. But watch, he remembers. Don Cherry says, don't lay there. I'm getting up. Yes, sir. A Russian's getting up. Look at this guy. He's hearing bells now, folks. He's asking where he is. He says, I'm in Siberia, I think. But anyhow, he gets up. Pretty soon, watch him. Look at that Joe Fahelman. That's kind of funny, isn't it? Anyhow, he gets up. Way to go. What's his first name?
Looks like a Bobby there with the strap under the nose.
What's his first name?
Slava. Vyacheslav.
Something like that. Now, we got one little thing at the end for you kids. I've always said, you kids exercise your arms. I know you do, your legs and everything else. The one thing, I've said this before, you don't exercise like football players, your neck. Now, we got a hit coming up here, Fedek. Now, watch this here one coming up. I always say, strengthen those neck muscles. Now watch this. See, he gets whacked here.
Kovalev, I didn't notice that. That was Kovalev put him in there a little.
Well, Kovalev, I call him carve a leg off. He knew the guy was coming. He's the guy that did it to Hunter. Anyhow, as we go, kids, and mom and dad, I've got a grandson, he's 10 months old. He's a hockey player in about a year.
Dell,
my Dell Cherry. And first thing he's going to learn is get his neck muscles straightened. So, and I'm not going to tell you the exercises. Go to somebody, some good guy to tell you, okay?
Brent Fedek, by the way, stayed in hospital overnight just for observation. Strained muscles, he'll be coming back to Philadelphia, is the story there. And if you don't work on those muscles, then the least you can do is get a protective collar.
It's your birthday.
It's my birthday.
Yes, at midnight tonight. You know the thing I think about all the success with your Rock'em Sock'em, your Grapevine, nice. Coach's Corner, and now this magical birthday, you can retire, right?
Can I?
Yeah, I think, is this the one? No?
Yeah, 61, you imagine? So good.
Tough and good looking. Here are a couple of pictures we brought along from a photo album. Don't know how we managed that.
There's my brother on the right, and that's my dad, 6'2", 234 pounds. That's our little dog, Juddy. Oh, where'd you get these?
There's Richard, 3 years younger, explaining to you how your toys work.
Yeah. Same old thing, eh? Oh, and there's my little dog, Juddy, again. Where the heck do you get this stuff? There's my brother with his finger in his mouth. Oh, look at a good guy.
Babe Ruth, everyone said.
Yeah. Well, I didn't have his name. It was stadium lunch.
Here, listen, I'll bring my earpiece out so you can listen carefully. We got a little special birthday greeting here from a mystery provider of the photos.
Oh, yeah?
Hi, Don. This neighborhood has changed a bit since we were kids, but this old house is still here. Tilly and I want to wish you a happy birthday. All the best.
Oh, a judo guy, black belt in judo. My brother played for Philadelphia.
Yeah, and you've been known to have a few belts, you just told us. There you have it. And Don Cherry. Double headers, the new tradition on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. By the way, this wasn't my idea to wish you a happy birthday. Now, Don, you've taken a lot of slings and arrows. I don't know if you've been reading the papers, but...
Are we to that time?
Yes, I'm afraid you got a little choked up in the opening.
Yeah.
And I wasn't sure you'd be able to go through with this, but I know you want to respond to the people who feel you're the leading
Rose
spokesperson.
For barbarianism.
Yes.
How do you say that?
Yes.
Barbarianism.
Close enough.
Anyhow, my boss is at CBC.
Rose, Fair Play Commission have all said, what have you been showing? Broken ankles, broken shoulders, cuts, fights. They want me, and I've been told I have to show the gentler side, the sensitive side of hockey players, all right? So we put together a little thing just to keep them happy. And here we go, and we'll start it. Are you ready to go? And this is our middle musical interlude with it, okay? And here we start right now, all right? You ready? Go! You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is still a sigh. The world will always welcome lovers as time. Sing along if you'd like. It's still the same old story. A fight for love and glory. A case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by. Did you like that?
Here's the pièce de résistance.
Oh, look at Dougie. Yes, isn't that beautiful? Captain Scott Stevens of the New Jersey Devils, the hardest hitter in hockey. Hey, you don't believe me? Ask Kozlov. Let's go, Scott boy.
Keep your head up, Kozlov. Wango. Let's see that again. Hey, Scott says, hey, Dino, you're next. Keep your head up and do your chin strap up. You're gonna need it. Hey, watch Scott and Dino battle it out in the corners. Hey, I love these two guys. Two good bull terriers going at it. They love it, and I love it. Okay, folks, let's watch these beauty hits. Hey, Scott wants a piece of you, even when he's sitting on the bench. Hey, watch McEachern put Scott right into the bench. I think he'll pay for that. The Bruins are gonna love Sean in Boston, I'm telling you. Yuskevich puts Beluso right into the Flyers' bench. But no one fools with Mikey. Domino hammers Chambers. Now watch Eric and Sean give each other a little shot. Hey, folks, this is a beauty. Cosentino puts Chambers right into the wings bench. Roenick and Kozlov have a little disagreement at the bench. No, Essa and Kozlov, funny, hey, folks. Hey, the Boston Bruins just won't let Cullen leave. Jimmy Kite sends Reichel for a ride. Hey, now watch this now. Claude gives Brent Lindros a little shot when he thinks the ref's not looking. Claude said, Brent, that's for all the things your brother did to me.
You know, a few years ago, maybe one, two, maybe three guys on a team could really hammer a puck. Now everybody can smoke them. No wonder the goaltenders have to wear masks like these. Hey, all right, watch these boys.
The Golden Brett. The Canucks of coin hammers one. Ho-ho, Sutter with a scorcher. Chelios smokes it top corner. No chance for Felix on that one. And it breaks the net can. Dave McKinnis sends one of his rockets home. Hey, Davey Ellett let this one go, and it has eyes. Mike Griggs smokes one. Chorsky along the ice on Roy. Oh, folks, that's a tough one just inside the post. Buckberger seeks this one home. Petit puts it in the top corner and Osgood. And my favorite, Cam Neely, zings one home. Okay, now, folks, Blues favorite, more bloopers. Primo really gives a stick to Guerin here. No, this is not the neutral zone trap. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Hey, can you tell it's had night in St. Louis? Hey, lucky it was a puck night. Nice promo for the hat, so. Jim Carrey plays this one like his Hollywood counterpart, Dumb and Dumber. Did Yerky play in that movie, Dumb or Dumber? I think so. And Gally says, look, Dominic, I had Pete all the way. Hey, the bravest man in hockey. And I'll tell you one thing, folks, this is the easiest goal Patty's ever gonna score. Poor Chris, he doesn't know whether he's coming or going here. Are you sure this isn't hard, he asked him. No wonder his dog bit him. And you know what, folks, Scotty Bowman, he showed this one on Mike's arbitration hearing. Hey, don't worry about it, Chris. Eddie should have had it. Eddie's having a tough time. We make funny Eddie the Eagle, but let's see him soar now. Pick for the MV of the playoffs, Martin Brodeur. We'll be right back.
What did you think of the little shot on Claude Lemieux?
Claude Lemieux, yeah, you help me through this, okay? Claude Lemieux, he didn't do his turtle act, he did his caterpillar act. You want the caterpillar act? This is the caterpillar act of Claude Lemieux, and it's a damn shame because he's a good hockey player.
You know,
show that?
When Dino was down
in the...
Are
we going to show the caterpillar?
Sure. When Dino was down in the first game,
there he is. That's a caterpillar. In hockey, we call that the caterpillar. This man is dead, never to rise again. Doesn't he look like a caterpillar? But he blossoms after that.
You know, folks, if he had fell here, I would have given him a 10. But I can only give him an 8. Good acting, though, I got to tell you. Hey, now here's a master, a 10 for sure. Great, great facial expression. Hey, the best goalie and the best goalie actor. Hey, does anybody know why Kovalev fell down here? I can't even rate it when I didn't see him get hit. Hey, Kovalev again, he spends more time on the ice than the Zamboni. Hey, this is sickening. I'm not rating it. Hey, watch Burby Craven tap Kozlov. He goes down like a sack of potatoes. Hey, folks, he doesn't even look like he'll ever get up again. You know what really hurts, folks? This guy gets up, dances around when he gets the winner in overtime. Can't rate him because of overacting. Sickening.
Gordie Howe, Mr. Hockey, 26 years in the National Hockey League. Can you believe that? He was big and tough, and could he put the puck in? Just like these guys.
Well, Burry isn't big, or he's not tough, but you gotta admit he can put the puck in. He's a beauty. Nice move by Jamie Baker. You know, folks, I gotta say something. Calgary caught a lot of tough breaks in overtime here. The puck hits something, and it bounces right out to Darlene, and he puts it in the net. Boy, that's a tough one. Nice tip by Pekka. They're gonna love this guy in Buffalo. Whitney in double overtime. Joe Sakic, a beauty. And my favorite again, Cam Neely. You want to see a pretty goal? Just watch Jeremy Roenick. And Captain Mark Messier from his favorite spot. Pretty, pretty, pretty Joe Sakic. And my rookie of the year, Jeff Friesen. Jeff says, that's a pretty good one. I gotta try that again sometime. Hey, folks, this is Turcotte. He has a one-hander. That's what I call a Forsberg. You know what I mean. Now that's sweet. Nice tip by Stevie Larmer. What a hockey player. Martin Jelena with some nifty moves. A beauty goal by Captain Shanahan. Boy, they're gonna love this guy in Hartford. Bill Guerin, folks, I gotta tell you something. You don't see anything better than that. Now that's hockey. Here's my buddy Bernie getting to it again. Steve Smith roughs up P.T. Chuck, and the Boston Strong Boy, he doesn't like it one bit.
Again, I calls it tea time. It's for you people that don't like the odd tussle. Go in the kitchen, put the kettle on, turn the TV off. Time's up. Let's go.
Brian Marchman and Cam Russell going at it. Look at those rights going. I'll tell you, two good lads. So many rights. Somebody's begging for a left, and here they come. Hey, my buddy Cam, I got him on three rock'em sock'ems. I love him. All right, get those elbow pads. That's off, that's right, that's it. Now look, now here's what you do. Now look, nobody's getting hurt here. The crowd is going nuts. One more shot by Brian, and Cam, he nails Brian. Hey, like I said, folks, I love these guys. Two good guys. Now the linesman moved in, and nobody's hurt. That's the way it should be.
To end it off and everything for all my buddies around, my good old buddies, a lot of Bruins guys there, firefighters, policemen, everything like that, that don't get to see the good fights. Watch this fight coming up. Turner Stevenson, Sean Atosky. Now it starts here. Now you teetotalers, go the other way. Now watch two good guys go. Get out of there, linesman. Get out of there. Let them go. Now don't be. Now here's two good guys going. Same old. Look at that. Now watch near the end, folks. Where Stevenson says, right at the very end when they get close, he says, good job. You won't believe it. And that's what I said. It was same as Marty and Probert last year when they patted one another on the head. You see the elbow pads. Once you get those elbow pads off, it's a lot better. I used to get mine off fast, by the way. No, I was pretty near the end. I just took them off fast. I had them cut down. Now watch, right? He turns around and he says, watch this. Good job. Watch this. Good job. That's it. Two good guys going at it. Hey, this is a great coach's corner. Hey, am I beautiful or what? Hey, we've got some great action for you coming up with my favorite music, the bagpipes, with Scotland the Brave. You ready? Let's go! June, I'm going to tell you how to buy the right equipment. And being a canny Scotsman, I'm going to tell you how to save money. Thanks for watching, folks. See you next year. Guess you better not. Well, folks, here we are in the Montreal Canadiens dressing room in the Hockey Hall of Fame. Boy, isn't it something. This is the most famous dressing room in sports. Of course, I was with the Boston Bruins on the other side of the forum in the little wee dressing room, but we won't go into that. Okay, and now's the time I'm going to tell you parents and kids how to buy the right equipment. You're going to hear me say over and over and over again, get the right size. And you know, kids, give your parents a break. You don't always have to have new equipment all the time. Hey, listen to this guy, what he has to say about new equipment. Now, you know, I like to help the parents out there. I know kids out there that I got to have new equipment, Daddy, and that. And I read in your book where your mom used to go to Shoppers Mart and things like that and look for used equipment.
Yeah, that's how we did it. Actually, it was my next door neighbor and myself, and we'd go from home to home. And if it was my turn to go first, I'd get the first pair of shin pads, and then he'd choose the second pair or whatever they had, and the next home he'd get the first pick at whatever it was, and I get the second. So we ended up having, I got all the used equipment, and I remember I got one brand new thing, and I got laces.
Laces, eh?
Red.
And then you pass them down to Brett, right?
No, they were
done, yeah. By you guys. See, you kids out there, you don't have to have new equipment and pay a small fortune. All right, now, we're going to start on the helmet. We're going to start at the top. Now, look, all these helmets fit perfect. You see that? But how many times have you mom and dads out there saw a kid going down the ice with the, you know, the helmet? He's pushing it up. He goes to shoot. Down and up it goes. He can't see. You get the helmet so it fits him next year. No good. It's got to fit snug and comfortable. And another thing, look, when he's out in the pond or out fooling around on the ice and that, always have the helmet on. That's when the kids get hurt. Now, you're going to hear snug and comfortable a lot. Helmet, nice and snug, comfortable, looking good, all right? Hey, this looks like one of my shirt collars, right? It looks pretty good. But I'm not kidding about this. Listen, never, ever go on the ice. I don't care if you're out fooling around. Always have your neck guard on all the time. This thing could save your life. My son, Tim, always had this on when he went out and played, and my grandson, Dell, he'll have it on too. Never, parents, never let them go on the ice without their neck guards. Right, kids? You better believe it. You know what ticks me off the most? I don't know why it is, the shoulder pads. I talk to the younger players. I see them out in the ice. The shoulder pads are too big. Now, these fit perfect. The kid can move. He looks like Wayne Gretzky standing here. He can move. He can do something. Now, I'm going to show you ones that are too big. Now, take a look at this. I know you moms are going to be mad at me out there. You're going to say, we need something like this. This could actually stop the charge of a bull elephant. It's too big. He's going to have a tough time. Stick Hal in that. The other one was right on the money. That's what the pros wear. Only guys who wear stuff like this is Ulfie Samuelson. This is RoboCop stuff. Have the shoulder pads nice. Come on, let's go. We can play the game. It's not football, okay? All right, shoulder pads. Now, too big, just fit right, snug, comfortable. This guy can move. This guy looks like Frankenstein standing here. I know, moms, don't get mad at me. This is a perfect shoulder pad. Now, you notice I'm saying this is too big, that's too big, helmet's too big. Everything's too big because your parents go out and buy things so they can wear them the next year, which is ridiculous. It's hard enough to play this game, like I said, without having equipment too big. For instance, let's take a look at these pants here. Way too long on this kid. Boy, I'll tell you, when he falls down, he'll never get up. And now I'm going to show you ones that are too small. Now we're going to show you something that's too small. Right here, take a look right there. Way too small. See that little right there on his leg there? My son, Tim, believe it or not, I'm the expert. His pants got a little small, got cut right across here. Cannot have them too small. I'm going to show you the perfect pants. Now, this is a perfect pants. Now, look at this. Right across there, not too long, not too short. You got to have equipment to fit you, folks. It is too tough to play this game with equipment that's too big or too small. Okay, elbow pads. Now, look, it doesn't take a genius to say you don't get them too small because you cut off the circulation. But these are too big. Take a look. Hits his glove, hits his shoulder pad, could fall off. hurt his elbow. Anything could happen. Never get elbow pads too big. Now take a look at these elbow pads. These fit perfect. Not down in his glove, not up in his shoulder pads. This kid can stick handle, all right? Get the elbow pads perfect. Not too big, not too small, snug. I love that word, snug. All right, we're gonna talk about gloves. Now look, you remember Mario when he got slashed by Graves with his gloves cut away down? The general managers and coaches and trainers are making the pros make them a little longer to cover it up. You know why? Broken wrists. Don't have gloves too short. Have them that they fit perfect. Cover up those wrists and protect those wrists. Hey, you know in hockey, you gotta be able to move those pins. And with shin pads like this, you can't move them. Too long, too big. Look, it goes way down into the skate. It's gonna be tough for the kid to skate. Way up in the pants. Too big, and don't get them too small either. I'm going to show you some that are too small. Now, just as bad as too big is too small. Again, too small here, you could get cut in the leg. If they're too small down here, you know the tongue goes down. That little space right there could get cut right there. Coming up, I'm going to show you the perfect size. Okay, take a look at these shin pads. These are perfect. Right here at the pants, they can't get hurt up under here. See how it goes right here? Down here, it's not too far down into the skate so he can skate. Try to get these shin pads, and coming up, I'm going to tell you how to put cotton batten in to save your knees. Now, I'm going to talk about shin pads and cotton batten. Now, I know you've heard me on Coach's Corner say this before, but listen to what I say. I know a lot of kids have put it in, and they say they loved it. Now, you know how it gets all sweaty out here? You big guys that are watching, too, listen to me what I'm telling you. The pros do it. A lot of the pros do it. This here gets like cement, and when you get hit on it, it hurts your knee. All you do is get the cotton batten, get the first layer, put that in there like that, and then when you fall on it, it's like a dream. It'll get a little molded to your knee, and after a while, you put another layer in there, and I'm telling you, you'll love it. Please do this. Save your knees. I'm telling you, all it is a roll of cotton batten. Now listen to me. Do it. Okay, folks, now we come to the most important thing in hockey is the skates, as you all know. Because if you can't skate, you can't play hockey. You gotta have them fitting just right. You can't put socks in them, you know, so the next year they fit. The kid wobbling down the ice with his ankles out that way. You know, I ran hockey school so long in Boston and Rochester, New York, and up here in Canada. I used to feel so sorry for the kids when they'd come up and their mom and dads had got them big skates. I cried when I used to see them. It's hard enough playing this game without having skates too big. The rule of thumb, as you know, one size smaller than your shoe. All right, remember that now. And don't, hey kids, give your folks a break. Like I've talked to before, you can use skates. The way they're made now, they're hardly broken in. Remember, skates have to fit perfect. Okay, I'm asked all the time, what about the hockey stick? How high should it be? Well, I'll tell you, if you want a good slap shot, you gotta have a bigger stick. If you want a stick handle, everybody will tell you, you gotta have a short stick, but you won't have that boomer of a slap shot. I always like to have them right about there on my skates, right there. It's pretty good right there. But remember, if you look at all the good stick handlers, they all have short sticks. But I like it right about there. But hey, the kids will find that out. They'll know how long they should be. Well, okay, here I am talking about water bottles again. And some of you people out there says, why is he always talking about these? Well, first of all, think about it. You could get colds. You could get the flu. But remember that dad in Mississauga where his son died of meningitis? He swears he got it off a water bottle. So listen, get your water bottle, put your name on it, and use that one. Don't use anybody else's. I know one thing, my grandson Dell's gonna have his. You know, kids, you're the luckiest kids in the world. I'll tell you why. Hockey parents are the best parents in the world. I'll tell you, you talk about being unselfish. You know, we're talking about, oh, you'd say, well, what about baseball? Are you kidding? You drop the kid off. And what does he do? He plays ball, and you pick him up after. Basketball, what do? You take him to a nice court, nice and warm. Soccer, nice field, sunny and all that stuff and everything. Hockey, you got to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning. You got to pay $100 an hour for the ice. You got to go in and freeze in those places. So I'll tell you, kids, let's give your parents a break. I don't know how many times I got to say this. You don't need new equipment. please, you heard about Eric, you heard what he says. Give your parents a break. You're the luckiest kids in the world because hockey parents, without a doubt, are the greatest people in the world. And I thank you for watching Rock'em Sock'em 7, and Lord willing, we'll see you next year.